Some people faint at the sight of blood, but me? I like blood. It keeps me alive and healthy. And I'm not a vampire. Those rumors are totally unproven. And now there's another reason blood makes me happy. Hey gang, Julian here for DNews. Researchers have developed a test for diagnosing depression. Well, they already had a series of questions they'd ask and would diagnose you based on your responses. But now, there's an objective test, and this time, it's your blood that has the answers. The test measures levels of 9 different RNA, which are large macromolecules that are synthesized from your DNA and are vital to how your genes are expressed. Researchers used a small sample size of 64 patients total. Half of them had been diagnosed with depression, and the other half were a control group. Just from the varying levels of each type of RNA, researchers could tell who had been diagnosed and who hadn't. More than that, about 40% of the depressed subjects had different levels of these RNA from the other 60%. And as it happens, all of them had successfully responded to cognitive behavioral therapy. So it's possible we can determine who will benefit from working with a therapist for months from a simple blood test. But even those patients still have much higher levels of 3 biomarkers than the control group, which could explain why most people have relapses into depression even after successful therapy. Granted, the sample size needs to be expanded before we can say with any certainty that this is definitive. But it is a step towards expanding our understanding of depression, and more importantly, it may help change the way we as a society think about it. It's estimated that in the US, about 10% of adults suffer from depression, and yet it's still something people feel ashamed to seek help for. Instead of getting real care, they try to fight it on their own, and sometimes it ends tragically. But if there's concrete evidence that some people are hardwired to be depressed, maybe those who need it most will be willing to seek help. There's no reason that suffering from mental illness should be any less acceptable than a physical one. Heck, sometimes it's even trendy to claim to have a physical disorder. Like, there's no evidence that non-celiac gluten intolerance exists, and yet my orange juice this morning proudly advertised it was gluten-free. If you're living the gluten-free life and don't believe me, Tara has an excellent video on the subject you can find here. And to end on a lighter note, let's talk about what makes you happy. Let us know the one surefire way to brighten your day in the comments. Like, for me, it makes me happy when people subscribe. I know, it's a shameless plug. I'm Julian for DNews. Thanks for watching.